Hello children, welcome back to your English class. I hope you all are fit and fine. Today in this video, we are going to learn grammar, lesson 14, conjunctions and interjections. We are going to learn about the kinds of conjunctions like coordinating conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions, correlative conjunctions and compound conjunctions. Let's read these sentences. I like skating and flying kites. I love playing chess, but I am not very good at it. I don't like chess because we have to sit for a long time. It will rain either today or tomorrow. The words and, but, because, and or are joining words. They join words, group of words or sentences. Joining words are called conjunctions. They are also called connectors or linkers. The conjunction and is used to join either the same parts of a speech or a noun and a pronoun. For example, Minnie and Rini came to see me. Second one, Rahul and I are going to the market. The conjunction but is used when something unexpected happens. For example, Rita is rich but unhappy. We expect a rich person to be happy, but Rita is not. Let's see the second example. The accident was serious, but she was not hurt. Here, if the accident was serious, we would expect her to be hurt, but she was not. We use or as a conjunction whenever there is a choice. Let's see the example. Do you want to go out or take rest? The second one. Keep the milk in the refrigerator or it will turn sour. Sometimes one sentence says something and the second sentence gives a reason for it. We can join these two sentences by using because. For example, I cannot go to school because it is raining. I shall come to your house because I want to meet your father. Let's see the definition of conjunction. A conjunction is a link word that connects words, phrases, clauses or sentences together. For example, I bought 5 books and 2 pens. He is clever but lazy. We asked him why he was late. Here, and, but and why are the conjunctions. They are joining the sentence with words or the sentence with phrase. There are two main kinds of conjunction. They are coordinating conjunctions and subordinating conjunctions. Let's first see what are coordinating conjunctions. So what is a coordinating conjunction? Coordinating conjunction joins together words, phrases or clauses of equal rank or independent statements. The coordinating conjunctions are for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. As there are only 7 of these words, there are just a few rules for using coordinating conjunctions correctly. It's a good idea to use the mnemonic fun voice to memorize coordinating conjunctions so you'll never forget them. Letter of each example makes mnemonics fun voice. It is easy to remember. Now let's understand what is subordinating conjunction. A subordinating conjunction joins a subordinate clause or subordinate clauses to a main clause on which they depend for its complete meaning. The subordinating conjunctions are after, so, that, until, whether, unless, till, where, before, and etc. A clause is a group of words which contains a subject and a verb. We can call a simple sentence a clause. For example, wait for me. Another example, is the lunch ready? See one more example, the girl standing next to Garrick is my sister. If a clause makes sense by itself, we call it a main clause. All these are the examples of main clauses. However, many sentences contain clauses which do not make sense by themselves. For example, unless you play, when the rain stops, these clauses does not make sense by themselves. We call these clauses dependent or subordinate clauses. It is always used with a main clause. Let's see the examples. Soccer match usually stops whenever it rains heavily. As you can see, the main clause stands by itself. A soccer match usually stops. It do not need the help of any other words to give it sense. But whenever it rains heavily is the incomplete sentence which need the help of other words to give it sense. The other example is, you can't take goods out of a store unless you pay for them. The main clause is you can't take goods out of a store, which stands by itself. And unless you pay for them is a subordinating clause which needs help of other clause or the main clause to give its meaning. See one more example. The game will start again when the rain stops. The main clause, the game will start again, makes sense by itself. However, when the rain stops, a subordinating clause doesn't. We can put a subordinating clause before or after a main clause. For example, a soccer match usually stops whenever it rains heavily. Or we can write, whenever it rains heavily, a soccer match usually stops. Remember, when a subordinating clause comes before its main clause, we usually separate the two clauses by using a comma. Now let's learn about the correlative conjunctions. Conjunctions are used in pairs. They are called correlatives or correlative conjunctions. They are either or, neither nor, both and, not only, but also, whether or, between and, hardly when, no sooner than. Let's understand through the sentences. Either keep silence or leave the room. The boy is neither clever nor active. He is both clever and respected by all. She teaches not only English but also history. Now let's see what is a compound sentence. Some compound expressions are used as conjunctions. They are even if, as though, as well as soon as if, as much as, so that, in order that. Let's understand through the sentences. I will get there even if I have to walk. She was pretty and acted as though she were a princess. They sell books as well as newspapers. As soon as I heard his statement, I became angry. So this was all about the conjunctions and its kinds. I hope you have all understood it well.